Here's what's coming up in the Category 5.tv newsroom. A frightening takeover vulnerability in the popular file manager plugin for WordPress is being exploited in the wild, giving attackers the ability to drop and execute code on around 700,000 WordPress sites. A U.S. startup unveils a battery made from nuclear waste that could last up to 28,000 years. On Thursday, 60 more SpaceX satellites were launched to join the rest of the Starlink fleet. The latest Windows 10 cumulative update breaks sleep mode. We'll share the fix. And Minecraft is making the jump to PlayStation VR. Stick around, the full details and this week's Crypto Corner are coming up.
This is the Category 5.tv newsroom, covering the week's top tech stories with a slight Linux bias.
From the newsroom, I'm Becca Ferguson. Attackers are exploiting a critical vulnerability in a popular WordPress plugin that enables an adversary to run arbitrary commands and upload files to a target WordPress site. The flaw is in the File Manager plugin, which has more than 700,000 active users and is designed to help administrators manage files on their WordPress sites. The plugin includes a third-party library called LFinder, and the vulnerability results from the way that File Manager renamed an extension in LFinder. The vulnerability was introduced in version 6.4 of File Manager, which was released in May. But it wasn't until late August that researchers first saw exploit attempts against the bug. An exploit for the vulnerability was posted on GitHub in the last week of August, and on September 1st, the maintainers of the File Manager released an updated version that fixed the bug. Although the fixed version has been available for nearly 2 weeks, researchers say not many of the WordPress sites running the plugin have updated, which means they are still vulnerable. Ramgal of WordFence said on Friday, "Sites not using this plugin are still being probed by bots looking to identify and exploit vulnerable versions of the File Manager plugin, and we have recorded attacks against 1.7 million sites since the vulnerability was first exploited. Although WordFence protects well over 3 million WordPress sites, this is still only a portion of the WordPress ecosystem. As such, the true scale of these attacks is larger than what we were able to record. The severity of the vulnerability makes it urgent to update, especially with automated scans for the bug ongoing. Identifying vulnerable sites is a trivial task, and with an exploit publicly available, time is of the essence, particularly given the fact that an attacker would be able to upload arbitrary files to the site after a successful exploit." Sick of your smartphone dying at 3 p.m.? A U.S. startup may have the answer, as they've unveiled a battery made from nuclear waste that could last up to 28,000 years. The power for the nano diamond battery comes from radioactive isotopes used in nuclear reactors. Its radioactive core is protected by multiple layers of synthetic diamonds, one of the hardest materials to damage or break. The energy is absorbed in the diamond and used to generate electricity. The battery can be used to power devices and machines of any size, from aircraft and rockets to electric vehicles and smartphones. Nima Golsharifi, CEO and co-founder of NDB, said, "As members of society, we are extremely concerned about the welfare of the planet and are focused on lowering climate change to protect our planet for future generations." He goes on to say, "With the NDB battery, we have achieved a massive, groundbreaking, proprietary technological breakthrough of a battery that is emission-free, lasts thousands of years, and only requires access to natural air in order to power devices." The company says the development of the first commercial prototype battery is currently underway and will be available later this year. On Thursday, another 60 SpaceX satellites were launched from the Kennedy Space Center in Florida to join the rest of the Starlink fleet. In just the last month, there have been 3 successful launches and deployments, making SpaceX the largest fleet of satellites in the world, with more than 700 currently in orbit. SpaceX founder and CEO Elon Musk wants to create a constellation made up of thousands of Starlink satellites that can offer high-speed internet anywhere on the planet. In March, Musk said that at the, He said at the Satellite 2020 conference, "The world seems to have an insatiable appetite for bandwidth. We're certainly happy to launch other satellites." If our appetite for bandwidth was insatiable before a global pandemic, we're even hungrier now. The plan is to ultimately create an interconnected network of about 12,000 small satellites in low orbit around Earth. Using a small dish, customers will be able to connect and get fast internet speeds, with rural and tough-to-reach areas being the primary market. SpaceX recently said it's building about 120 satellites a month. Astronomers are concerned the extra points of light will make it harder to observe the night sky. Analyst Carmi Levy says, "They're trying to look at things far away in the cosmos, and you have all these pesky little satellites orbiting in front of them, causing streaks across their imaging." SpaceX has responded to the concerns by modifying its satellites to make them less reflective. The company hopes to use Starlink internet as a way to fund the company's vision of going to the moon and to Mars. SpaceX says the service will first be available in the US and parts of Canada. Public trials are expected to take place later this year. They said Friday that Starlink has already seen extraordinary demand from potential customers, with nearly 700,000 individuals across the United States alone indicating they are interested in the coming service.
The latest Windows 10 cumulative update has broken sleep mode, and we'll share with you the fix. Also, Minecraft is making the jump to PlayStation VR. Becca has these stories coming up, plus Robert's here with the Crypto Corner, so don't go anywhere.
Welcome back to the world of cryptos, and welcome back to the Crypto Corner. I hope you're well, and I hope you survived the recent correction in the market without any harm. This week, I'd like to focus on something that I touched on before, which is DeFi, decentralized finance. And the reason is that some of our viewers started asking questions, hey, isn't DeFi a scam? Why should I be part of this year? So let me answer you those questions. First, no, it's not a scam. It's on the contrary, it's going to be the future of our financial system as we know it. And yes, you should definitely be part of this year. Now, where's this coming from? And if we look at this website here, you can see that if you would provide ample ETH as liquidity, you would get over 1,000% APR. And that sounds like magic, right? It doesn't sound very real, especially if you would put money in your normal account in your traditional bank, you would probably get 0.5% APR. So why is this number so big? And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go into the detail of where this number is coming from. And I'm not going to be going too much into too much detail, so I'm simplifying a lot, but you will get the idea. The first part is, if we look at the rates of where the market is in the crypto market, it's not that much different from the traditional bank. Yeah? So USDC, if I would provide USDCs to for example, Aave, I would get 2.1% interest. If I would borrow at Aave USDC, then I would get 4.4%. So far, so good, right? So that's not different. So that's part one. Part two is if I would provide liquidity. And for that, we go to something called Uniswap. And Uniswap is where you can exchange tokens. So if you've got ETH and you want to buy, let's say, Band, then as you can see down here, you would have to provide a liquidity provider. You would have to pay a liquidity provider fee, and this year. And if you would provide money into this pool, so if you, in other words, you provide ETH and Band, so that other people can participate in this year, then you would get part of this fee, most part even. Yeah. So it's very simple. You click on pool. You click on add liquidity, you say, what is it going to be? And then you approve this year, and that's it. That's all you have to do. So that's how you provide liquidity. That's something that is unknown in the current market. Yeah, that's reserved to banks, market makers, Federal Reserve. You're not allowed to be a market maker in the traditional market. Crypto market's different. You can be participating in that. The fourth one is something that we know also in the traditional market. And there are high incentives. And let me show you some examples. First one is here with credit cards. If I sign up with this blue cash preferred card, they would give me $250 straight away. Or if I would go with Chase Sapphire, there's a bonus value of $1,200 attached to this card. So as you can see, there's also marketing costs that they are investing in that you will participate of. So that's one way of how the so-called traditional market is incentivizing you to be part of their network. Other example is flights. Yeah, I can book a flight now at the moment from Dallas to Las Vegas for only $36 return. No airline will survive on those rates, but they do that to attract people to fly on this day with that airline on that journey. If you book that a day before, that will be probably $300-$400. Same with air miles. why do they give you air miles? So that you can book then after a few flights a free flight. Same thing, it's just they want to attract you to be part of their network. And the third one that I forgot to mention before is staking rewards. So if I would take, for example, Tezos to secure the network by proof of stake, then Tezos would give me, in this case through Coinbase, 5% staking fee. Yeah, that's just by keeping my money, my Tezos, in a wallet and not using it. I would receive 5%. So there are a few incentives that are compared to the traditional market equivalent and not that much different to the DeFi market. Now, the beauty of the DeFi market is its software. It's not just some people sitting there and deciding what the interest rate is or what the incentives are going to be. It's a software platform that you just participate in, and it's neutral. Nobody will ask you for some weird passport pictures or so. You just be part of that. And that's the strength of this year. So these software packages or software platforms don't have high costs in building people and so on. They're just a bunch of people that coded something, they put it online, and that's why they can offer you so high interest rates. Now, before you really dive into this year, I would like to show you two websites that are important. The first one is here, defisafety.com, because here you can see which platform is really safe and which one isn't safe. So if I take Aave, for example, which is one of the big ones, then they have got a score of 84%. And why? It's because execute code validation, 96% documentation, because it's all public available. They documented everything, 90% testing almost done. Audit, like in a traditional market with finance, where you've got an auditor to review your books. So they do that here with the code. So it's a third party that reviews your code, how good it is. So this is pretty good. But on the other hand, you've got something like Based, that in principle did not do anything really. I mean, they just put the code online and didn't even test it beforehand. There's nothing is documented, and an audit was done only to 20%. So this is something that I would really be careful of. Yeah, unless you know what you're doing, I would not be part of those that are in here in red, because it is a little bit dangerous. Well, that's the first website. The second website is one where you can learn a lot. It's defirate.com. This includes everything in relation to the decentralized finance market. Yeah, so if you want to learn how insurance can be done, and what the lingo is, everything in relation to DeFi, yield farming, and so on, you'll find on this website. It's very well explained, and I can only highly recommend you to be part of that. Anyway, I hope I was able to explain to you why it is important that you participate in this year. Just play around a little bit. Don't plan to make 1,200%, just make 100%. But at least be part of this year and learn more about DeFi, because as you saw, it is going to be the future. Anyway, that's it from me today. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you learned something. I thank you very much for watching, and I'm looking forward to see you next week again. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thanks so much, Robert. Now, if you're watching, we are not giving financial advice. This is educational purposes on how the cryptocurrency market works and things that you need to know and different tips and tricks. You know, as we've always said in the past, you know, and as Robert has said, you know, only invest what you're willing to lose, because the market is very volatile. It's always on, and things can change in a heartbeat. So again, we're not giving financial advice. It's just more so education for you.
All right, we're going to throw back to Becca. Here she is.
Thank you, Robbie. Having trouble sleeping? The latest Windows 10 cumulative update breaks sleep mode, causing laptops around the world to become insomniacs. We have the fix to yet another Microsoft update blunder. Microsoft's September 2020 optional update seems to be causing some trouble for those who are running Windows 10 version 2004. While the update comes with fixes for critical issues and improvements, like many of Microsoft's previous cumulative updates, this one is far from perfect. Some users are reporting that the optional update broke Windows 10 sleep mode. With the update installed, some users are reportedly facing an issue where their PC keeps waking up from sleep mode. One user states on Feedback Hub, "When I close the lid, press the power button or select sleep in the power menu or the WinX menu. Instead of sleeping, the screen simply turns off, and my laptop does not go to sleep even after leaving it alone all night." Similar complaints can also be found on Microsoft's forum website. What's worse is that at the time of broadcast, there isn't a fix available from Microsoft. There's a temporary solution available if you're affected, though it's a bit hacky and reminiscent of the old up, up, down, down, left, right game hacks of the 90s. First, you need to stop the Windows Update service, then start it again, then restart it, then do a check for updates and install the pending updates. Once they're in, reboot your computer and you should be good to go with a working sleep mode. Minecraft is making the jump to PlayStation VR. Minecraft is already available in VR form for Windows 10 with the Oculus Rift and Windows Mixed Reality, plus there's a Samsung Gear VR version. Minecraft PlayStation VR is based on Minecraft VR tech from these other VR platforms. Mojang Studios executive producer Roger Carpenter said, "Everyone who has Minecraft on PlayStation 4 will get that patch automatically. Download that patch and you'll get access to the new Microsoft VR functionality. Of course, you'll need a PSVR setup in order to use it." The ongoing COVID-19 pandemic forced them to adjust how they develop Minecraft, Carpenter added, but the process was relatively drama-free. Skybox Labs, also working on Halo Infinite, helped Mojang work on this release. The Minecraft PlayStation VR experience will retain everything from the base PS4 version and will add a bunch of new settings. This includes two ways to play the game, immersive and living room. Mojang didn't expand on what that means, but if we were to guess, the latter may feel like sitting in a virtual room and playing on a giant screen. Mojang didn't reveal whether Minecraft PlayStation VR will work with the upcoming PS5. Sony has said their PlayStation Move Motion controllers, PlayStation VR Aim controller, and PlayStation camera will all work with supported PS VR games on the PS5, but it's not yet entirely clear what that means. Get your PlayStation VR ready. The free update drops later this month. Thanks for watching the Category5.tv newsroom. Don't forget to like and subscribe for all your tech news with a slight Linux bias. And if you appreciate what we do, become a patron at patreon.com/category5. From the category5.tv newsroom, I'm Becca Ferguson.